that you're going to need for your project. When you're finally done, there are a few things that you're going to want to add right off the bat. One of them is, as you can see, we need an FS command, which allows us to make our movie or our project fill a full screen. And one way we do that is by coming up here and in our first frame of our very first scene in our very first movie, one of the things that we want to put in here is FS command full screen is true. So here's the property, here's the condition, it's true. That allows your project to fill up the full screen. You don't have any gray around it, you don't have it sitting in the middle of a page. It literally takes it and fills up the window. So if the window is made bigger, if it's made smaller, remember this is vector, and what happens in a vector program is it's all math based. It's not pixelated, it's all straight lines and circles and arcs. It's all by numbers, and so your images will not be distorted in any way. The other thing that we want to do is that we want to be able to scale buttons and text. And FS command allow scale true does just that. So when the window is made smaller, the text becomes smaller, the buttons become smaller. When the window's made larger, the text becomes larger and the buttons become larger. Otherwise, you're stuck with little bitty text and little bitty buttons when you make that project bigger. So we want to be able to scale them proportionally to the project. The other thing that you want to always have in a project, especially in your book, is you want to be able to have an exit button. What the exit button does, and what we've done here, is we've programmed it, we've made a little button that says exit, and we've gone in and said on release, we have another command that says quit. This, when you make your project, you're going to save it, you're going to do file, publish preview, and you're going to make it a projector. And what all that does is, when you make it a projector, it becomes a self-actuating program, and it has a piece of flash in it so that anybody can use it. You can put it on a CD. It'll automatically start up and fill the full screen with these commands. It will scale the text and scale the buttons, and the exit button works in the projector mode. Now, it's not going to work. Let me show you this. It's not going to work when we test the scene. Here's the scene. We click it. You can hear me clicking it. Nothing happens. This only works, okay? And it doesn't work if we save it as a movie. This only works when we go to publish it as a projector, okay? So if I go to publish this as a projector, here it is. I hit exit, and sure enough, it closes the movie down. Let me go ahead and show you how the controls work. Here's my test scene. If I make this window larger, notice my text becomes smaller and my button becomes smaller. It still is a button, but it becomes smaller. I make it larger and my text scales itself, so it becomes larger as well. The text becomes larger and it scales with the window. Now, you'll notice that the full command, the full screen command, also means that my whole window, the movie takes up the whole window. I don't have any gaps. I don't have any backgrounds. I don't have anything that I don't want. And it doesn't sit in the middle of the screen like it would, let's say, if you had a web page and you had everything centered. If you took Dreamweaver and you centered your web page in the center, it would automatically be in the center. If I made the window bigger, depending on whether we had it set up by percentages or by pixels, you know that that window, when it becomes larger, that web page sits in the middle. Okay, so this is one of those great options that I think you should definitely use all the time. It allows the window to become much larger, and notice that the text is bigger. If I resize it, it automatically means it becomes smaller as well. But please remember, unless you make this a projector, this exit button's not going to work. That exit, that command, and you should always have a quit command in your program so that if somebody wants to exit the project or exit the program or exit the software, it allows them to do that. But remember, you've got to go to File, Publish Preview as a projector. Okay, if you have your default set up as your projector, then you're good to go. That's not a problem. If you save it as a flash file, though, okay, an SWF file, it is not going to work. So you've got to make sure that when you're using the quit command, and remember, it's easy to program the button, an exit button, and it doesn't have to be a button. It could be, it's going to have button properties, but it doesn't have to look like a button. It could be a door. That's a common symbol in navigation now to exit a program. It could be the big red X, the big red box up here in the corner with the X. Same situation. You want to make sure that your user understands forward, back, pause, stop. Make sure stop and exit are not the same things. Okay? So when you put your project together, these are the commands, these are the things that are going to come up first. This command also probably would have a stop in here, so you would probably also remember you'd probably have stop in here if you wanted to have your intro stopped right here. So remember, you are going to have an intro introducing your project. Look at the other student files and see how they did it. You want to introduce yourself or introduce your project. Then you want to have your main navigation come up, and that main navigation should cover your book. Should give the user the ability to go to the book, go to the color book, go to the drag and drop, go to the puzzle, go to a printed page if you want to be able to give them printed color book pages. That's pretty simple as well. But these are some things you want to really think about. If you have any questions, give me a call or email me, and I can explain this better if this tutorial wasn't complete for you. I hope it helped you out, and if you have any questions, again, give me a call or send me an email.